In part one of our lesson on products and quotients of complex numbers, we will derive the product rule and the quotient rule. To start off with, let's consider two complex numbers, z1 and z2, where z1 is equal to r1 cis theta 1, which we know is shorthand for r1 times the cosine of theta 1 plus I sine theta 1, and z2 is r2 cis theta 2, which is shorthand for r2 times the quantity cosine theta 2 plus I sine theta 2. To develop the product rule, let's take these two complex numbers and multiply them together. So we have R1 times the quantity cosine theta 1 plus I sine theta 1 times R2 times the quantity cosine theta 2 plus I sine theta 2. We can take the R1 times the R2 and put that out front. And now we're going to FOIL these two binomials. So we will do FOIL. First times first, we get cosine theta 1, cosine theta 2. Then we have to do outer times outer. So we get plus I cosine theta 1 sine theta 2. Inner times inner, we get plus I times sine theta 1 cosine theta 2. Then last times last, we have plus I squared sine theta 1 sine theta 2. Let's keep that R1, R2 out front. And I'm going to reorder these terms a little bit, simplify a little bit. We'll keep the cosine theta 1, cosine theta 2 first. Now over here, we know that I squared is going to equal negative 1. So that means this fourth term is going to become minus sine theta 1 sine theta 2. Now both the second term and the third term have an I, and we're going to factor out the I, so plus I, and I want to write this term first. So we'll have sine theta 1 cosine theta 2 and then plus cosine theta 1 sine theta 2. Now let's watch what happens here. The R1, R2 continues straight down. Now look at what we have here. Cosine theta 1, cosine theta 2, minus sine theta 1, sine theta 2. That is just cosine of theta 1 plus theta 2, using the sum identity for cosine. Then we have plus I, And when we look at what's inside the parentheses here, we see that that is just sine of theta 1 plus theta 2 when we use the sum identity for sine. And we look at this now and recognize that that is just the trig form. So we can write this in the simpler form as R1, R2, cis, theta 1 plus theta 2. So now that means when we want to multiply two complex numbers, we won't have to write all of this out anymore, because we know it's just going to become R1, R2, cis, theta 1 plus theta 2. So we will multiply the radii, add the angles, done. It's a really easy rule to use, and it's kind of an amazing, simple, elegant result here. So this is the product rule. Next, we will develop the quotient rule. So here, we want to take z1 and divide it by z2. So we have r1 times cosine theta 1 plus I sine of theta 1 being divided by r2 times cosine theta 2 plus I sine theta 2. Now remember, in the denominator we cannot have an I, so we are going to rationalize this by multiplying by 1 in the form of the complex conjugate of the denominator over itself. So that would be cosine theta 2 minus I sine of theta 2 divided by itself. So let's take this R1 over R2 and keep that out front. Now we will need to FOIL out the numerator so we can get that going. And we get first times first is cosine theta 1 cosine theta 2. Outer times outer, we have a minus sign there, so we'll have minus I cosine theta 1 sine theta 2. Inner times inner will be plus I sine theta 1 cosine theta 2. Last times last will get a minus I squared sine theta 1 sine theta 2. In the denominator, we are multiplying complex conjugates, and remember we just learned a rule for that. When you multiply complex conjugates, a plus bi times a minus bi, you end up with a squared plus b squared. So in the denominator, we are going to end up with cosine squared theta 2 plus sine squared theta 2. So we'll continue to keep this R1 over R2 out front. let's write this first term first. So we have cosine theta 1 cosine theta 2. And now we'll go to this last term, the I squared we know is negative 1, so that means this term will turn into plus sine theta 1 sine theta 2 . The second term and the third term both have an I, so let's factor out that I. And I'll take this third term and write it next, sine theta 1 cosine theta 2. And then the second term is going to be minus cosine theta 1 sine theta 2. In the denominator, cosine squared theta 2 plus sine squared theta 2 becomes 1 by the Pythagorean identity. Now next, let's bring down that R1 divided by R2. Looking at these first two terms, we see that this is just the difference identity for cosine, so it becomes cosine of theta 1 minus theta 2. Then we have plus I times, looking inside the parentheses here, this is just the difference identity for sine, so it becomes sine of theta 1 minus theta 2. And this is the trig form. We can write it in its simplest form by saying that this is R1 over R2 cis theta 1 minus theta 2. So to divide two complex numbers, we just divide their radii and subtract the angles. So this is the quotient rule.